Hi everyone, my name is Esther and this video is part of Esther's Ministries. Thank you so much for watching. This is part two of how to deal with a crisis or how to handle when crisis hits you in your life. Before I start, as always, this is the Word of God and please read it because in it there's wisdom, life and freedom. So please read the Word. So today, once again, I talk about how to do when crisis hits you. Maybe you have lost a loved one, or you are in the middle of divorce, or the coronavirus has given you a job loss, or whatever the situation is. Crisis is crisis, and crisis is a horrible thing. But we have so much more in us than the crisis that hits you. We have the Holy Spirit that living inside of us. So we do not have to lay down on the floor, start to scream and yell or call all the people we know because we are in a crisis. No, we have somebody better who wants to help you one-on-one. He wants to help you and guide you through your crisis. Not only through your crisis, but through your whole life. And that is the Holy Spirit. Please, when crisis hits you, the first part you can do is start speaking with the Holy Spirit. You can ask Him, what can I do? What direction do I need to do? Or what is going on spiritually? What is going on? Why is this crisis hitting me? And how to handle and how to react? And it is so important for us to handle the correct way. Because if we are panicking, it will go worse. Because we have John 14, verse 26. And it says as following. And this is such a beautiful scripture. And it says, but the Comforter, the Holy Spirit, which is the Holy Ghost, whom the Father will send in my name. So it is already in us. He shall teach us all things and bring all things to your remembrance, whatsoever I have said unto you. With other words, He will bring to remembrance the Word of God. He will guide you what to do through the Word. But the first thing you need to do is you need to make, in a split second, you need to make a choice. Are you going to lie down and scream and panic? Or are you going on your knees? And I want to give you a testimony. Long ago, my husband and I wanted to buy this beautiful apartment we are now living in, and we were busy with a mortgage with the bank. And one day on my job, I received a phone call from the bank that we were in a terrible situation. We would have a debt of $20,000 or euros, so that's a huge amount, and we do not even have a car, or we do not. That was just a debt because there was something. It's a very long story, so I will not go in debt with it, but we would receive a debt within a split in a few seconds. So when I heard this phone call, the first thing I would get, my knees were shaking and my body was shaking. I thought, oh no, that is a huge amount of money. And in that period of time, I was just out of debt. And I thought, man, I was out of debt, and here I am receiving new debt once again, all over again. So in my mind, I wanted to panic and scream. But I have read and have eaten those verses. So what I did, I told my colleague, because my colleague was looking at me from, what are you going to do? Because this is not a good situation. I went to the toilet. I went to a bedroom and I find a private space for myself. And I kneeled down at the toilet. And somebody would say, that is gross, kneeling at the toilet. Well, I would say my situation was gross. My situation was more than gross. So I needed the place to, I wanted to kneel down because I wanted to make a point. I wanted to say, hey, no matter what crisis hits me, I will not let my heart get in trouble. And I will ask the Holy Spirit, because He is my Comforter and He will guide me through life. And I will live by it. And I made a choice in my heart and I said it with my mouth. And I can say you, within hours, within on the same day, my debt was canceled and I was free from all horrible of this whole situation. And I believe that my crisis situation only turned around because I chose to be with the Lord. And then I've also had other crises, for example, a loved one. And unfortunately, the situation couldn't be turned because this person just left planet Earth. And it was a horrible situation, but there was something I received. The moment I chose the Lord, I received already a sort of healing in my heart, because the first thing I did was to choose God and God only. I asked the Holy Spirit what to do next, and then we need to act upon it. Because here in James, this is also a beautiful scripture. I say about every scripture, this is a beautiful scripture, because it is. But it says in James 1 verse 5, if any of you lack wisdom, I don't have enough wisdom. So this is for me. If any of you lack wisdom, let him ask of God that give it to all men. Not only to Esther, not only to your neighbor, not only to a pastor or not only to an apostle. No. Let him ask of God that give it to all men liberally and upbraid it not, and it shall be given him. But let him ask in faith, nothing wavering. For he that wavereth is like a wave of the sea driven with the wind and tossed. So when crisis hits you and you speak to the Holy Spirit what to do, don't go in with, yes, okay, I will do this. No, I will do that. Don't start wavering. Just act upon what the Holy Spirit is saying to you. And people will say, well, I just don't know how to hear his voice. That is a lie also, because everyone can hear the Holy Spirit. It is this, his word says it. The only thing is when you are not hearing him, when you think you are not hearing him, you are the crisis situation is speaking louder to you than the Holy Spirit. Because when you want to hear the Holy Spirit, sometimes you need to be in a more quiet place, as I did when a death hit me as a crisis. I went in seclusion. I went to a small part, to a toilet, because there was rest and quietness, and I would ask Holy Spirit what to do, and he guided me step by step. And what he can do for me, he can do for you also. I'm not a better person, or I'm not a freak, or I'm not such a great believer. No, I'm just a human being just like you, and I just choose to walk with the Holy Spirit and ask him and say, yes, guide me and I will do it. Because my own wisdom is nothing, and my own wisdom is less than the infinite wisdom of the Lord who made heaven and the earth, and it is available to you and me. So please, when crisis hits you, let not your heart be troubled. Choose the Holy Spirit and ask him, what can I do? What do I need to do? Help me. And he will never let you down. He will help you in detail. And that is one thing for sure. So see you at the next video, because what's next? And because most of them, when crisis hits you, it is as a process. But that's in the next video. Bye.